Hi everybody, this is Jose with Dedoose, and today we're going to give you a quick tip on linking your descriptors to your media files automatically. Now, before we get started, I'm just going to give you a breakdown of what you're looking at. Right now, this is a demo project in which I deleted all descriptor sets. So there are no linked descriptors, and we can verify our media, actually, just to make sure that everything's set to zero under this descriptors column. I'm going to go ahead and pull up this Excel file I created. And what I did was export some descriptors, or one of the descriptor sets, and I added a new field called title. Now this will have the document titles in it for the descriptors, and it's what we're going to use to automatically link everything. One thing you want to note is that these document titles must match the document titles in Dedoose exactly, including any sort of suffixes like .docx or .doc. A really easy way to get this is to actually go to your media section, click select all, and then export a list of your media. And it's really as easy as that. Now, I'm not going to do that now. Since I've already prepared everything, let's just go ahead and import this and get it linked up. Now, I'm going to go to the Home tab, actually. We'll click Import Data. Just like any old spreadsheet, I'm going to select it. Now, I'm going to go ahead and pull this up. So the format for this Excel file is going to be the first row will be the list of column headers, which will have your descriptor fields here, and this title column. It doesn't need to be titled title, but it does need to have the list of documents in the same row as the descriptor. For example, 19.06 and 19.06 here. And that's been imported. We'll note that our descriptors are all added. We can verify this via the descriptor ratios multi-chart. But none of them are linked, which we can verify via the codes by descriptor chart. We can verify this via the media tab as well. We'll see that descriptors are zero. And last, we can verify this via the descriptors tab. We can go ahead and click check all so that we can see the full data set. We'll see all zeros. But of interest, we have this new title field I added, which will have that set of document titles. So all I'll do is click auto link. I'm going to select my field title. I'm going to hit continue. Now this will tell you how many media files with the appropriate document titles are in there. Once you hit yes, it'll automatically link all 89 of those. We'll see. These all have one link to them. You can click the media tab. And this will have a bunch of ones as well. You'll see the occasional zero if you have media files which were not included in that descriptor set or that Excel file. This is because this new Chinese document actually wasn't part of the original data set, so that's totally fine. If I click home, we'll see the codes by descriptor chart fully populated. And since this data set was already excerpted, we can actually get started on coding right away. Now, one caveat here is that this will not automatically link descriptors that have a dynamic field associated to them. Dedoose will not be able to tell what document is pre or post, for example. And in that case, you would really want to do it manually. But really, that's about it. So if you have any further questions, feel free to send us an email to support@dedoose.com or give us a call to 866-680-2928. And I hope you all have a great day. Bye.